can IT shield the economy from the pandemic? And in particular, can IT also mitigate the job losses coming from social distancing? And Nico Pierri, and I'm going to talk to you about information technology in the United States and economic resilience during the COVID-19 pandemic. Working from home have become the norm for so many of us around the world. Contactless delivery and contactless payments have become more and more common, and online sales have surged all across the world. What do all these economic remedies to the pandemic have in common? Well, they are all enabled by information technology. And previous research have shown that information technology, also called IT, has led to so many economic gains. For instance, has led to a higher productivity and higher firm growth. This very sharp drop in mobility has caused an unprecedented economic crisis, as both consumption and production hit hard. In particular, job losses have been dire. For instance, in the United States, unemployment rate has skyrocketed during the spring of this year. Thus, we decide to dig deeper into this question. And we focus on the spring of this year, so kind of the first phase of the pandemic. And we focus on the United States, also because in the United States, there's lots of data about information technology, unemployment, and people's mobility. In particular, we rely on the fact that the extent to which people stayed more home, and so the extent to which mobility dropped in different parts of the United States has been quite different during the spring of this year. A bit because infection rates were quite different in places like New York City versus some southern states. In part because, you know, different governors and other local authorities decide to adopt different policies. I leave a virtual floor to Yannick Timmer.
Thanks, Nico. Now let us compare US states with each other, depending on the level of IT adoption of the firms within these states. This graph shows the result. IT adoption can mitigate the economic consequences from social distancing. On the horizontal axis, we show the extent of social distancing in each state, measured by the decline in mobility of the people living in these states. On the vertical axis, we show the change in the unemployment rate of that state. Let's focus on the low IT states first. There is a strong relationship between the extent of social distancing and the increase in the unemployment rate. More social distancing is associated with a stronger increase in the unemployment rate. This is not the case for high IT states. More social distancing isn't associated necessarily with a higher increase in the unemployment rate. Let us compare two states with each other. Nevada, a low IT state, and Colorado, a high IT state. In Nevada, the unemployment rate went up by around 25 percentage points, while in Colorado, the unemployment rate went up by only 10 percentage points. Quite a significant difference. Of course, Nevada and Colorado are two very different states. We know in the United States, the unemployment rate went up to around 14% in April and May 2020. IT adoption increased quite significantly over the last 5 years. So if the world would have been hit by the pandemic 5 years ago, we calculate the unemployment rate would have gone up to 16 instead of 14%, a 2 percentage point difference. This is quite a significant difference just because of IT. But does IT adoption shield everyone? We know certain parts of the population have been harder hit by the pandemic than other parts of the population. This graph shows that IT adoption mitigates the economic consequences for males, females, for high educated individuals, for whites, and for non-whites, but not so for low educated individuals. This means that inequality is unlikely to be exacerbated by IT across races and across genders. But it can increase inequality between high and low educated individuals. This means that everyone should receive IT education so that the benefits of IT adoption can be widely shared across the country. In addition to that, we show that IT adoption can mitigate the economic consequences of the pandemic. That also means that the cost of lockdowns or the cost of social distancing is higher in low IT states.